Who's next? Player. Player's chosen a track. He's going to get his Mac on, I think. I don't want to reveal too much. Player, what have you got up your sleeve?
So the track that I've chosen for this episode, maybe Captain can help me out with the date of release.
It came out on the 18th of February, 2001.
Very interesting. As part of the MPGMC shows?
Yeah, but the track itself, you're looking end of 1994, yeah.
And the track we're referring to is Mad. So I'll start by saying that I heard this track around about the same era that it was recorded as a bootleg. And yep, there it is. The gasp now. And I used to do a lot of record digging in the city. I would go.
I was going to say bodybuilding. It's like your bodybuilding song. <you know? laughs>
What the
hell? I don't know.
I'd go to like all these record stores and just buy hip hop albums and sample CDs and all sorts of stuff. Anyway, I went to a record store in Sydney called Soul Sense, which was, it's just kind of like the back of the metro. And I picked up a CD there called Fat Jazzy Grooves, and it was labeled Volume 6 and 7. It was kind of like, it was one disc, but apparently it was two albums on one disc.
That's not there anymore, is it, that music shop?
No, it's gone.
No, now it's a Korean restaurant.
That's right, yeah.
But I bought a 12-inch of Damn You in that record shop.
Right, cool. I've got some stories about that record store. But
and now they're serving up 12 inches of noodles.
Anyway.
We don't want to hear about your 12-inch noodle.
Well, hang on. At least they were both serving the chicken grease, so.
Exactly.
Anyway, so I picked up this CD, and on this particular CD, which was called Fat Jazzy Grooves Volume 6 and 7, there was a track on it called Bebop to Hip Hop, and the artist was called Headshock. That song is sampled in this Prince track, Mad. And it was kind of interesting because I heard the bootleg of the Prince song, and then I had the actual basis of the song as well. Mm. So it was kind of cool. So to me, it's kind of he's straight ripped. It's not even like, it's even more than a sample. It's more like a steal almost, because it kind of incorporates the whole song into it. He doesn't really sort of mess with it or add too much instrumentation to it. So,
oof.
So it's a pretty cool track. I think the inspiration is, you know, this was around the time where, you know, it's the name change thing. And I think he got a lot of press saying that he's gone mad. And, you know, I don't know if this is before or after Slave on His Cheek, but, you know, he was going through this phase where kind of mainstream and Warner Brothers and all that, it was just kind of really being shunned and stuff. So I think maybe that's the inspiration for the song. This was apparently considered for the Exodus album. There's a version of this recorded by Sonny T that's in the vault. So I'd love to hear that. Probably my favorite part of the track is where he says, you know, turn on the dirty switch and back up far before he does the guitar solo. I think that's really cool. And then I don't even know how to describe it, the musical break at 4:33, which got recycled into Rock and Roll Is Alive and It Lives in Minneapolis. So it's a really cool little piece of music. And I think he used it in Get Wild live performances as well.
Sounds like one of those things he would do live, like kind of little segue riffs.
Yeah.
Segue into different grooves and things.
Yeah. I really like that part of the song. And I really like that, you know, it ended up on multiple different songs as well. So I really like it.
All right. Kojem, what do you think?
I got some stuff. I like this. It's fun. It's playful. It's got a really 90s big beat kind of groove to it. You got these two chords, a minor seven chord, then a half diminished chord, these kind of sustained ones that just kind of go back and forth between the two. You got that real classic, like 90s dog whistle, high pitched synth hook kind of thing. You've got lots of references to other songs in this song. You've got the hus from Sexy Dancer. You've got this little bebop alto sax line, which is also used in The Good Life Big City Remix.
Ah, yeah. Yeah. That's straight off that track that he sampled.
It could be, yeah, okay. And there's also a little classical piano bit, which is very reminiscent of When Doves Cry and Thunder and those sort of other harmonic minor piano lines he would do towards the end of these sort of songs. I mean, I've said here he sampled scatting, and you hear this in the background, this dub-a-dab, dub-a-dab, but I'm guessing that's also from the original
thing. Yeah, it's all from that bebop to hip-hop. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Which sounds like Scatman, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's just review that song. Beep up the hip hop by Headshot. Let's do it.
So, I mean, I like that because it kind of fits the mad theme. Like, you got this kind of mad scatting going on in the background. Prince goes a bit crazy towards the end where he's, I'm about to go mad, sort of plays around with the timing and he starts laughing and it's getting pretty dangerous at that point. It's very thick. It's very distorted. It's heavy, but it's kind of a jokey kind of song. I like it when they play this live on the Café de Paris, Beautiful Strange, VHS. And Prince is like looking all crazy and he's like looking at the band like, should I do a stage dive? And then he just jumps into the crowd and then they put him back and he's like, should I do another one? And he's like, no, no. And then he just jumps back into the crowd again, you know, while the mad groove is going on. It's kind of cool. So when I hear that song, that's the image I get. Just, you know, crazy Prince on live, just doing crazy stuff. And I mean, I remember when it did come out in 2001 or so, I remember thinking then like it sounded a bit dated, like it sounded it was from the early 90s. And so it's hard to take it out of that. It'll always be like that, which is maybe not a bad thing. I wouldn't say it's a mad song, but it's a good mad song.
Captain.
This is a good song. He spent some time on this song. This has got a lot more. This has got a lot of sound effects and all these little added parts all over the place. The chorus is really busy. There's like scratches and there's grunts and there's like these whip cracks everywhere. You got the sleigh bells all the way through, just like 18 and over. And in the verses, after almost every line, there's like a callback to something in that line, or there's a sound effect, or there's a vocal. There's always something. Like, he worked this track. There's these big breathy synths, like in both the verse and the chorus. You've got bebop to hip hop sample, like the whole track pretty much. You got great vocal part, 2:45 to 3 minutes. It's just classic Prince. Toe Jam said that he's just getting more and more crazy and that he's just laughing like an idiot. There's a massive like whip crack at 3:08. It just loud, so loud. It's great. And then you got all these random little guitar parts start coming in all the way to the end of the song. 3:46, you've got the typical 90s stabby keyboard parts. But this is what we're all here for tonight. Everyone's mentioned it. This is one of the best endings to a Prince track ever. It's not actually right at the end, though. Just, you know, you thought the synth bit at the end of When Doves Cry was good. That's got nothing on this. This is way better. 4:33 to 4:52.
And Captain just, officially goes crazy.
It's how just bloody, it's so good. It's amazing. This is why I love this guy and all this crazy shit that he did. It's insane. It's one of the best things ever.
Yeah. You know what it reminds me of? The end of It's Going to Be a Beautiful Night. That's kind of...
Oh, yeah. You know, just the big end. Yeah.
Kick some ass, you know?
It just goes off. Yep.
Yeah. But he does that, like these little musical arrangements like within the songs that are really cool. Same sort of thing.
So good. It's 20 seconds, but it's 20 seconds of like the best thing you'll ever hear in your life. So it's
Captain,
good.
Captain, are we sure that was him or was it Headshot again?
No. This was all him.
Yeah. Okay. Just checking.
And yeah, it was used in, I think you said Rock and Roll is Alive. It's at the end of that.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
I have a feeling it may have been used as a segue. I might be completely wrong here. In like between Delirious, like around 98, I can hear this kind of at the end of Delirious. I don't know why I'm getting that. Like the performance on that Sinbad show. Remember that where he's wearing the black thing?
Could have been.
Could be that, maybe.
He used it live a few times here and there because it was so good. He just kept using it. That's why. And it's like you listen to it and it's not just like he's playing one part. There's literally like four or five different parts that all go at the same time. And you can just listen again and again and again and listen to different parts.
Yeah.
It's insane. I can't say anymore. It's just for that 20 seconds. It's one of the best things ever.
It makes
one of the best things ever. That's a big call.
Remember there was a song on Emancipation. It could have been Get Your Groove On. I can't remember. But there's literally like 30 seconds in that song, which is just perfect. There's nothing that you would ever even change about it. This is the same. It's just 20 seconds of the best thing.
You know,
there's
what you
nothing
should do?
To change.
You should
take, there's nothing
you should
to add.
Take the excerpts of all of the like just average Prince songs
prank.
That you love. Yeah, and make your Captain's Remix, your favorite crazy
part. I'd die. I couldn't even make... The mix, I'd just drop dead a third of the way through it. It's too much.
Do you know what that would sound like? All the old field listeners will know. If you did that, I reckon that would be Prince's version of Amarok. That's what it would sound like. If you did that.
There's something to work on. Okay.
Okay, if you're done, I don't have too much else to add because you guys had a lot of what I had in my notes. But I will say that this groove is pretty much just a similar, it's as similar as any other mid-90s groove that he was putting out around that time. And it's a good track and it's got the Mac rhythm happening and all this sort of stuff. Player spoke about, you know, Prince going through the slave period and being upset with the record and all this sort of stuff. But this song, in my eyes, and I think if you read the lyrics closely, sounds pretty clear to me that it's about just getting it on, and he's just going out of his mind because he wants to clock it. Like he wants to knock the boots, as they say in the US. He wants to get it on, like this chick or whoever this person or these people are. He's just racking his brains, tearing his hair out. Basically, he's going absolutely crazy because he just wants to get it on, and he's getting out of control. So, to me, this is like a full player. Pardon the pun. I didn't mean the Peach and Black podcast player, but like player.
It's style the same song.
Track, yeah. As it should be, actually. But wow. I would have loved if this went on the Exodus album, whether it was with Sonny's vocals or Prince's lead vocals. I couldn't care less. Like, it would fit perfectly on that album. Even on Come, possibly. But I'm splitting hairs now. And that great guitar squirting. And yes, I said it. It's guitar squirting at the two minutes, 20 seconds mark when he asks everyone to stand back and he basically goes for broke with his guitar solo there. Sprays everyone in the room, all the record execs, yeah, all the women in the room, all the groupies. It's one of those moments where it's like, it's clearly that's what he's doing, but he's so clever, like he doesn't go completely overt about it. But anyway, this is an interesting song. Prince in full-on sex-crazed mode and backed up by a pretty solid groove, although it is, like I said, pretty standard for him. Like, he could pull these sort of songs out in his sleep. I will say,
the groove itself is good, but it is standard, but it's all that stuff he puts on top of it.
Makes it better.
This is a really busy song. Like, there's like, you can't go 2 seconds. There's something happening. Like, even just in the verses, he'll sing a line and then
it is a busy song.
At the end of every line, there's like a backing vocal or there's a sound effect. There's like always something there.
And I didn't know why that was, whether it was just him being super creative. But I think maybe now that I've learned from you guys that basically the loop of this track and a lot of the rhythm track is based on this other song by Headshock. Or was it Bebop to Hip Hop? Maybe Prince was like, well, I've got to do all this shit. Otherwise, it's just a straight rip of the song. Mm. So maybe that's what he was thinking. I don't know. But yeah, I mean, this is cool. I'll certainly listen to this. If I've got 5 minutes, I'll listen to this over Jukebox with a Heartbeat without even thinking twice. So